Hello there. Let us now look at the use of say if, then, while, then, do while, then, for. We will take an example, an exhaustive example, and try and look at all these control structures. So let us define a task now. The task would be accept a value, say an integer value n from the user, then print the first natural numbers. First n natural numbers, including a zero. This is a simple program. But to do that, what I should do? First I should accept an input. To accept an input, I'll echo. This is called echoing because the user should know what he wants to enter. So enter n, value of n. So scanf percentage d and of n. I need to declare the value of n to be 0, or I just say n. Now if I want to display the first natural numbers, first n natural numbers, you know that a property of a natural number is it will start from 0 to infinity, which is a countable infinity, and all natural numbers are positive whole integers. So if I now want to do that, means every time I had to just start from 0, then the next value is 1, the subsequent value is 2, so I get a series. Okay, if I want to look at the logic, my natural numbers are like this: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this up to countable infinity. Alright, so I could see a pattern of just a display statement by incrementing the value of something by 1. So I am just repeating that entire concept n number of times. So I can now have a iterative structure. Iteration is repetition of some logic. So I can either use while, or I can either use for, or I can either use do while. Okay, but the issue is if the user says I want 0 natural numbers, then no output should be printed. Correct? If the user says 1 natural number, then the output should be 0. If the user says 2, the output should be 0 and 1 that way. Okay? So let us look at solving this problem using a while statement. For this, I need a counter in terms of how many values I am able to print. Okay, I will say while, so my counter will now start from 0 to n. Now I will say while my counter remains less than or equal to n, just print the value, print f. What is the natural number? Print f percentage d, okay, comma, I just print the value of the counter, which is looping from 0 to 1. Finished, that's it. Alright, so I can also make some echo here. The first n natural numbers are percentage d in this case, or start from a new line when it is displayed, I'll say n. Okay, this is my code. Okay, good to have these errors. So I have to give a semicolon, I mean double quotes here. Then we had one more error, which is again the same error. Okay, and this is what it is. So this particular thing, what it does is it carries out a single statement or a block of statement. If I have to represent as a block of statement, I have to give enclose this in a flower bracket. If this condition is true, the moment this condition is false, this doesn't execute. Alright. So let us see. There will be some logical error, which we will see. First, we have to eradicate the syntax error. We had some syntax errors. So I have no error now. OP. Now I'll enter the value of n to be 0. Okay. Now it has gone in an infinite loop. That is because I have value of counter has permanently remained 0. Since the value of n I have given as 0, since 0 is less than 0, okay, then equal to, which is less than or equal to, this condition is always indicating 1, which is similar to if I say while 1, regardless of whatever is my input. If I do something like this, whatever may be the input, doesn't matter, it just loops, because I have given while 1, 1 in C is. You may ask me, what about minus 5, minus say 1, 2, right? Okay, so it's any non-integer, right? Okay, non-zero, all right? So it doesn't matter. So one is fine. So if we go back to our condition, we had said what? We said count is less than or equal to 0. Alright, so we need a block because we need to update the count. So since before entering the block, I am checking for conditions, this is called an entry control loop. It's a conditional loop, of course, to begin with. The entry condition is at the entry. So in that case, it is called as an entry control loop. So I'll say count equal to count plus 1 as if the first number has been printed. Okay, so now if I execute this code, okay, I have to declare this is counter. I have made it as count by oversight, which is fine. So I now execute this code. Okay, we have still have to give, oh, I have not saved this code, that's the problem. Save it. Okay, so I do the OP. So now I say 0. It says the first 0 natural numbers are 0, means it is giving an error. 0 means it should not print anything, isn't it? So now for that, I can make what condition to be whatever. So what I will do is, if the value of n is 0, right? Correct? Now I could say if my counter is less than 0, for example, right? Counter is less than or equal to, you know, in this case I have to give n. Okay, if my counter is less than or equal to n, now what is the problem there? The value of n is, okay, if I give 0, It is a logical error. It compiler doesn't know. Yes, this condition is true, isn't it? Now for that, what we should do is, there are several ways of handling this thing. One is, you could say, I'll make this as minus 1. Correct? The moment it is minus 1, minus 1 is not, is minus 1 less than or equal to n? It is. Isn't it? So even then, we have an issue there. Correct? So if at all, if the value of n is 0, I should not enter the while loop at all. Correct? So for that, what will I do? I will say if it is less than count. If the counter is less than n, correct, then print. If the counter is not less than n, then don't print. So is 0 less than 0? No, so it should not print, correct. So in that case, I will do the OP. The value of n is 0. Now it, the first natural numbers are nothing, it has not displayed anything. Similarly, if I now give say 1, it gives the first number, one natural number is 0. Now if I give say 10, okay, 10, my first natural numbers are 0 to n minus 1. So if you now see this, our logic has actually worked. Suppose if I use a do while instead, correct? Suppose if I do use a do while instead, I will say do while, and I say do. Now this is the bottom exit control loop. Now regardless of the value of n, it does execute these two statements because we are checking the condition in the end. So the when to choose what loop depends on if your logic wants something to be 0 or more, you rather use while. If you want to use 1 or more, you have to use do while. This is extremely important. There is one more, unconditional looping. Okay. Now what is the meaning of unconditional looping? I know that instead of using entry control or exit control, I will use a counter when I don't want to increment the counter at all. I will initialize the counter by using something called a for statement. I'd say counter, I start with counter is equal to 0, and I know counter is, if it is, as long as the counter remains less than 0, I'll say counter plus plus. It's not less than 0, it's less than n, correct? Right, now this I have eliminated, become now very short. Let us see, this is unconditional looping. Even if I am checking condition, means it loops regardless of the it just repeats n number of times, okay, or whatever is the number of times we want it to loop. So I do something like this and I do the OP. So if I now say 0, no, 0 natural numbers are that. So if I say 10, so it gives me 0 to 9. It's the same logic again. So you may ask me, how can I choose? How do I know what to choose? Is for better, while better, do while better? Do while, anyhow, we know it, if it is one or more iteration. For and while, we can actually have zero or more iteration. So if you want to check for a condition at the top, use a while loop. If you want to just repeat until some condition is met, that is also true. So it is again English, right? If you say, sir, for me, while and for look similar, so be it. We will really put there a thin line between these two control structures. As long as it serves the purpose, is fine. In the subsequent lectures or in the subsequent examples, we will try and see how do I gauge intelligence or competence to know how to choose which control structure for what kind of logic. Hope you understood this concept. See you in the next lecture. Thank you very much.